Welcome back to another edition of Golden Fox Plays. Well, I'm continuing Donkey Kong Country. By the way, somebody get a vomit bag for Bliss over there. So, yes. Yes, I do too. Because Keyframe has not been feeling well, she's going to be resting for a bit. And hopefully she might come back later. Maybe not. We don't know. But she needs her rest. We have the same crew as before, Toon Critic, Lightning Bliss, Sapphire, and Aeon of Dreams. So,
hi.
Entering the Gorilla Glacier. I used to have so much challenge with this one. Let's hope I make it through with the breeze. You know what? No, take it back. You guys want me to rage.
No, Goldie, just let it go. Eh?
Don't.
Let it go!
No!
It
go! No! You son of a...
Can't read my... No, we can't read my Brooklyn Rage. I don't wanna be a furry. Okay.
Brooklyn Rage?
Oh my what? God, what?
He was above me. That was bullshit.
From you, Abridged.
Bop, 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 poker face, bop, bop. God dang it! I hate that song! What are you sighing about, Top Hat?
He's thinking of Bo.
Tails the Scout, thank you for following. God damn it, I tasted the pit again. Excuse me. That's right, fuck you, vultures. God damn it.
The vultures. The vultures are mean. Those are picked on us. Literally, they're picking on us.
Well, see, that sounds like something you say when you're dead, but like half of you is still alive.
Yeah. So got it.
You know, I'm tempted to reference something else, but the stream is not NSFW.
It is when I'm here, dearie.
Oh, yeah. Alright, so you want me to quote it?
If it's a one-time thing, go for it.
Okay. You want me to choke you with my cock? Is that what you want? No, please, button. Not again.
That what you want?
Get on your knees, bitch. God. Get on your knees. Open your mouth. Open it. Yeah. Take it, you whore. Take it.
Did you see the animation for that?
Yes, I did. Oh my god.
I don't want to see that. Does that sound safe for Bliss?
Yeah, I'm saying Made Edits. Made Edits is a really good animator.
I regret allowing
Why
this
is there
to
a
happen,
freaking ice cream truck in February?
Lesson learned.
Go Snapper. That sounds like Butt Scratcher.
Butt Scratcher!
Butt Scratcher!
Butt Scratcher!
Butt Scratcher!
Butt Scratcher!
Butt Scratcher.
Oh my god, we're such nerds. I got a question. Why are there crocodiles in the snow? They'd be dead by now.
Yeah, they would be. They would not last long.
The dude's like, shh. It's okay. Ow. I question everything.
Wee.
Holy shit! Tucky mushrooms!
Okay, there was like... I don't know where it was. God damn, the music got intense.
And the snow's picked up, I can barely see anything.
I know. Oh shit! Shit! Oh!
Oh no!
Woohoo!
He's okay!
It's still blizzardy out there, it's ridiculous. Do you have a favorite kind of ice cream? Yes, actually, chocolate chip cookie dough. And I went and plummeted to the pit. Whatever.
Marbles like Oreo. Mwah.
Fuck!
Red velvet.
I thought I jumped in the barrel. God damn it. Things got quiet real fast. I hope there's not a problem with the stream.
No.
Eating fruit.
There shouldn't be.
Alright.
Fruit of God's garden.
Oh shit.
But yeah, marble slabs, red velvet cake ice cream. Mm.
God damn it.
Good shit.
And if anybody ever sees it, they're going to automatically think, oh my god, Blissey, you're such an edgelord.
And I launched myself in the pit. Great.
What, that you like red velvet ice cream? Oh yeah, so fucking edgy, am I right, too?
Oh my god.
Yeah, totally.
Peter, the ice cream is like blight.
Fuck!
Bright red. Like blood red colored.
You're really, really stretching it to call it edgy.
Oh, I see. Just because something's red automatically makes it edgy. Is that what you think? Is
okay,
that
what I'll push it over the edge.
Okay, I see how it is.
I will push it over the edge. I will put chocolate syrup on it. Now it's red and black.
You know what? And white. Fuck you, Bliss.
Oh, shit.
You know you love me.
And strike.
You know you love me. Do you want me to test that?
Shut up.
I'll test it. Chad, do you want me to test it?
Oh, damn it. Oh my god, I'm getting my ass kicked here.
I'll be surprised if they say yes, test it.
Oh,
I wouldn't be surprised because the chat wants everything.
I am getting my ass handed to me.
Yeah, people are like saying yes, test it. I'm not surprised.
Oh, okay. Test the love. Hey, let's go to Candy Mountain.
Yes.
I'll get marinapped.
You don't need to do that.
You don't want me to do that, or I don't need to do that? Choose carefully.
Why don't you stay here, though?
Let me see how many lives I can get.
Yes.
Okay, I'll test again.
Oh, wheels of steel. Oh my god. I love what he says there.
Oh, okay, fine. I'll go snuggle A on space then.
Okay. Fine.
I'm manipulative. I can't believe it. I am a manipulative little alicorn. I'm surprised. I didn't know I had it in me. I surprised myself.
Darchan, I don't know if I've seen your question yet. Let's see. No, I love that somebody quoted off of Let It Snow.
Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Yeah. Oh, the weather outside is frightful. But the fire is so delightful. God damn it!
Just there's no bananas to eat. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. The poacher's notes are signs of flying. And they keep on wanting us to be dying. But as long as you love me so, let it snow, let it
snow. Fuck me. Oh shit.
Oh, when we finally spin the barrels. Oh, I hate getting stung by the bees.
Nobody
but
does.
But if you really hold me tight, all the way through this game, I'll be fine.
I overshot and I launched myself into the goddamn pit. Let It Snow versus Let It Go. Let It Snow would win.
Let It Snow.
Yeah.
Let It Snow, Let It Snow, Let It Snow.
Not kill a classic.
Yeah.
Yee.
Oh, I'd rather... come on.
I know this would be a bit of a stretch, but I wonder if me and Doc were to do what's the song? Baby, It's Cold Outside.
You know that?
Not safe for Bliss.
No. The lyrics don't mean what you think they mean because if you had heard that song in the 1950s, it would still be a pretty innocent song because those words don't mean the same things they did in the 1950s.
What song?
Maybe it's cold outside.
Yeah, like the idea that we know what the song means is actually kind of stupid because if you knew it in a 1950s context, it's not saying at all what you think it's saying.
Oh,
what does it mean?
Like, it explained what most of the terms of phrase, like, there were some terms of phrase and slang in the song that date it, But if you knew what those meant, the song is actually very, very innocent.
Well, I mean, from today's standards, and I only prefer one version of it,
Yeah, but, by today's standards, it's kind of like a... It's kind of a date-rapey song, as Watchful Pony just put it. But, like I said, in the 1950s, that was never the meaning of the song. In fact, it didn't even have anything close to that. It's just that the turns of phrase used just didn't translate well with time. That's it's kind of like how, if you listen to Blinded by the Light, the lyrics sound like they almost mean something like childishly lewd, but if you remember the time the song was written, none of that was ever tolerable. Part of the meaning. Yeah. None of that was ever part of the meaning. If it wasn't tolerable, it just wouldn't be in the song.
Well, I listened to the Rod Stewart version, and I mean, from what I get, it's literally just a girl being with her man for a night, but she's been staying too late, obviously, and needs to get home because her mom and dad will be looking for her.
Oh, that is not what the song is.
I thought it was a love song about a guy who, like, is in love with someone who's blind.
Wait, because what song are we talking about?
Blinded by the
Baby,
Light.
It's cold outside.
I'm confused now.
Me too.
Because there were lyrics that says, Mama always told me never look into the eyes of the sun, but Mama, that's where the fun is. Ow!
Hey, baby, I wanna know. If you be my monkey.
What?
We're playing Donkey Kong. I gotta keep to the rep.
Revved up like a deuce, another runner of the night, blinded by the light. Oh shit! And I got stung by a goddamn bee instead.
I guess you did get blinded by the light.
It'd be like.
Right.
It'd be like, God would just say, like, sun, come into the light. Ah! It burns!
It burns, burns, burns! Sorry, not sorry.
Oh.
Blinded by the light.
Oh my God, that was close.
Well, I suppose I could blind somebody if I shine a rainbow right in their face.
No! Damn it! Oh,
that you can't be.
Fuck. This fucking stage, man, it sucks.
Yeah, I think you repeated the stage more than the mine one.
How long have they been on this stage? This is like ridiculous.
Use the force.
Okay. Get it. There we go.
Not the bees. Oh boy.
Bees, come on, get up there.
Alright.
The bees!
Get the fuck up there! Dude, get up there! Oh my God.
Bee movie, but every time somebody says
really?
Bees, it flows.
Really? He fell right through that platform!
Just go, go, go! You're losing time!
Go!
You're not even catching anything!
Yeah, you know why?
Oh, Big Mama.
And it was not even worth it.
Yeah.
It wasn't
Golden,
worth it.
Golden, stop dying.
You know, easier said than done, Safi.
I thought I'd remind you anyway, stop dying.
Too Critic, are you the real Slim Shady? Am I? Last I checked, I was.
Yes, he's Too Critic. Yes, he's the real Too Critic. Yes, the Critic can't sing for shit. Oh, I need to stop singing.
Oh, come on!
Shaq, stop dying.
God damn.
Okay, guys, don't do that. Don't spam the chat with that. That'll just piss him off.
Well, they're not going to realize that until we... until, like, 20...
What the fuck was
yes,
I doing?
That was not called for. Please stop.
What happened?
Hashtag get good.
Oh, that's not that bad.
Yeah, it's not that bad. I mean,
it's really not that bad.
Hashtags are just hashtags. They don't really bug me that much.
Yeah, we're not.
Unless
like,
you're Lily Pete.
At least he wasn't saying like get good faggot.
Oh yeah, that'd be bad.
No, like if somebody is like throwing insults at me in the chat, they're like they're just asking to get banned. And there's people who will actually do that. I've heard so many stories. God damn it. There have been so many stories that Keyframe has told me when she was modding, I believe it was Breezy's chat, or it's one of her friends. Shit!
Didn't we tell you to stop dying?
Shut up!
No, Savvy, you sound like a really bad Dom. I told you to stop dying, now it's time to get out the crop.
Take your time on the barrels, Goldie. That's all you can do. Take your time.
Alright.
Take your time.
Damn it! I took too long.
Mad. Job, man.
God damn it.
Unleash the magic.
I swear, like, I feel like I'm one of the few people who actually like friendship games.
I liked it.
It was okay.
Yeah, like, I love that moment where, the Altar Twilight, is, like, she's defeated by Midnight Sparkle, and, like, after she gets blasted by that beam, like, you see Sunset Shimmer come in, and she goes to lend a hand to her. And, like, the reason why I find it so beautiful is because this is just, like, it's her passing the torch for somebody else who's had the experience of what she's been through. And I just like that they took that direction, showing that, yeah, I've made some mistakes. Excuse me, I made some mistakes, too. Ugh. I mean, it could just be for the sake of character study, but that moment just, like, it touched me. Shut up, Peter, I know what you're gonna say!
Sorry, what? I was reading a thing.
Okay.
For once, the Lucifer was distracted.
Oh no, Fox is just talking about how games touched him.
He touched the butt.
Hey, Zach!
What?
Crawling in my skin.
You know, that song actually doesn't bother me. I think it's a really stupid, edgy stereotype.
It is the stupid, edgy stereotype. And you know what the sad thing is? Everybody keeps assuming that song is either the definition of people who are edgy or emo. Because they think... No, they assume that crawl under my skin is slip my wrist, crawl under my skin. No, that's not what it means. It's about Chester Benning. Thank you for following. My name is Ashley. Mm-hmm. You mean Ashley? I don't know, but crawling was not about that. It was about Chester's drug addiction to crystal meth.
Oh.
Yeah.
I figured it was drug addiction.
Yeah.
But...
Like,
no, I thought it was. I heard cocaine.
It was something around those lines, and sometimes some people like to cook it on a spoon. And if it gets really hot and it gets on your skin, it burns and leaves a scar. That's what crawling on my skin, these wounds will not heal mean. Not, I'm cutting my wrist. Because what relevance will you have with the rest of the lyrics? Fuck!
Nobody listens to the rest of the lyrics.
Yeah, people are very quick to judge. And I'm very quick to getting my ass kicked in this fucking stage.
I do have another song, though, that's more edgy.
Fuck!
It went like...
How can you see into my eyes?
No, it's not even that.
It was, Welcome to my life.
Oh God, Simple Plan is it like, even on the levels of like emo music. God damn it, I did that for
like
me.
Like you feel like you just don't belong and no one understands you. Do you ever want to run away? Do you lock yourself in your room?
Oh, I know what song you're referencing.
Yeah.
No yeah. one hears the script.
Let me share a little piece of something. If there's any band that I absolutely detest, it is Simple Plan. And even a, like even if you were to judge the band as a quote-unquote emo band, their music is still garbage. I'm not going to say that emo music is bad music or anything like that. You can have some very insightful music. That's part of what made the genre popular at the time. Like, I'm actually one of the few people who liked the Black Parade album from My Chemical Romance, and I just launched myself in the pit. But
nice. Honestly, okay.
Simple Plan, they're just a bunch of whiners every time I listen to their lyrics. Like,
you know, I think...
Go ahead.
I think the most emo song I've ever heard in my life was this. I don't know if anybody's ever heard of it, but it goes like this. Ahem. I'm just a kid and life
that's
is
Simple
a
nightmare.
I'm just a kid and I know that it's not fair. Nobody cares because the world is having more fun than me. I'm just a kid. Has anybody heard that song?
That or is it just Safi, that's also Simple Plan. You know what's also Simple Plan? Say it with me now. How could this happen to me? I made my mistakes. Got nowhere to run. Life goes on as I faded away. Like, people like are arguing, saying that it's about drinking and driving. It's like, no, bitch, you don't even clarify that. It's somebody complaining. If you're going to write a song about a certain subject, make the lyrics specific about that.
Well, even though I should probably point this out, that is kind of the reason why people look at crawling in my skin that way is because you can apply it to an addiction, but it's never explicitly made clear.
The thing people most readily
associate it with are the emotional issues that you go through in junior high.
Yeah, I love what Chuckle D. Buggle said. It's a never-ending loop of the game. Yeah, this is probably one of the most frustrating stages I've had in a long time. Oh, shit. Come on, get up there. Come on. Oh, God damn it. Get back in the barrel. There we go. Yeah, it's a never-ending loop. How about I Miss You by Blink-1... You mean Blink-182, right?
Yes.
Again, like how Josh interprets Luna from Magic Sheep. What is he talking about?
Crawling in my skin!
Oh, Josh overblew that. Like, yeah. I get that he was joking on that, and then I saw a supplementary video, which was much better elaborated.
You're making good progress so far, I think, on this game.
This one stage, man, this is like a giant block on the road that I'm trying to push off. Come on. Spider-Man, whatever does Spider-Man can. Fuck!
Spider-Man, does whatever a Spider-Man can. That's what he's referring to.
Ah. Whoa, shit. There we go.
Apparently you're the angry video game nerd of this community, Fox.
Really?
You know? I can see that.
You know, if that's the case, then I also enjoy the reviews of James Rolfe for a much more common collective. So I would kind of take that as a compliment. Wow, come on!
Ow! Ow!
Ow! Oh my God.
There's kind of a charm to those old songs, though.
Yeah.
I bother to remember
absolutely.
Them.
If... Go ahead.
Like, a lot of pop punk has a lot of really cynical stuff, but you grew up with pop punk.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And no one, I've noticed no one ever really has any bad memories of the pop punk song. Like, it's probably because you grew up with it. It may not be the genre that you remember the best, but you remember it because you grew up in the 2000s when it, like, it started in the 90s, started to pick up and went into the mid-2000s, so it sort of grew up with you.
Yeah. It's kind of like my parents with, like, old classic rock.
Yeah, I'm pretty much with Safi there. I mostly grew up with classic rock. I used to be under the impression that whenever it came to modern music, I always thought of it as the similar aspects of what was like Slipknot or bands who like to scream into the microphone. Like, I just like, how, why do people enjoy this?
My mother actually enjoys that.
Huh, okay. But no, like, I used to be, like, very, very cynical about modern music, and I just got my ass kicked again. Fuck! No, I like the Atari's cover of The Boys of Summer.
Oh, you know, Boys of Summer, at least according to Turk, was actually the, even the original version of it was considered to be, I think, the precursor of pop punk, if not the first pop punk song.
Huh.
At least that's what Turquoise Flash tells me.
Somebody's being very, very close on the microphone. Yeah, what's up?
We built this city!
We built this city on rock and roll!
Built this city!
I'm just gonna say this. I grew up on things like, obviously, pop punk, alternative techno. Something else, though, is that I did listen to a lot of old stuff, but one of the more interesting things that I sort of grew up with was
Chuck
British
Oldman.
Rock
and don't do that.
British rock and British alternative. So, like, I know most of these guys are just from Genesis, but, like, I didn't grow up with the Beatles, but I did grow up with Peter Gabriel, Phil Collins, and Genesis.
Phil Collins. My mom listened to him a lot. I grew up, because my dad would play his bass music up, like, almost every night, I heard a lot of, Beastie Boys, AC/DC, Metallica, Stevie Ray Vaughan, B-52s, Ozzy. My mom loves the Beach Boys, so I got to hear them a lot too. And
yep.
I remember liking Stevie Ray Vaughan the most out of all that.
Okay, also Cybermurph.
There has to be a hidden barrel here somewhere. I remember that there was a barrel that took me across from the bottom. I don't know where it was, though. Just, I gotta figure that out. It's not there. Now, like, this could, like... Is it down here? Damn it! No. But it took me to some kind of game, okay. Fuck!
I'd ask everybody, do you prefer Peter Gabriel or Phil Collins' Genesis? I guess Phil Collins, because that's the most I'm familiar with?
Yeah, a lot of people are familiar with that one. When it came to the other one, it was mostly art rock, which is the type of music that not many people think too much about or get a connection with. Let's see, did you see my question for Blissey? No, what was your question?
Hang on, I saw it. Let me scroll up a bit.
How long have I been recording this episode?
I have no idea.
I don't know.
2 hours, 7 minutes. Oh,
was
no.
Was there a question for me?
Yeah, there was like a... Crap, I'm trying to look for it. It's up here.
Somewhere. The rainbow, way up high.
It actually involved, like, a rainbow mask type of question?
Oh, Deverer, I remember you.
Yes, I do remember.
I remember the question, but I didn't know what the mask was, so I think I kind of skipped over it. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I think that's what it was, like... Also, guys, if we skip your question, we're sorry, but if you have to, like...
There it is! Woohoo!
Yay!
Did you finally make it.
Golden Fox, did you start the fire?
It was always burning since the world was turning. Yes! Yes! Okay, now because... Yay! Okay, now guys, because I've been on this stage for such a long time, I'm going to cut this short and start another episode. Don't worry!
Yay!
Yeah. I'm going to stop right here because this this stage took me forever. until next time, I'm Golden Fox and keep gaming.